Welcome to the Matrixers, Jonathan and Shiva. Exactly. Today our really exciting topic is the analog and the digital self, i.e. the everyday self and the knowing self. So today we have the topic of the digital and the analog self. The aim is to gain an understanding of the analog self. And I think each of you has already gotten to know the analog extensively. This is your everyday self or ego personality, you could say. Tell me, I'm busy. So the self that you deal with on a day-to-day basis. Exactly. And the digital self, that is, the knowing self. That which really knows everything and also decides and makes the arrangements with other knowing selves, which you then play through in everyday life. For example, when you switch from an everyday self to the digital self, it's a bit like suddenly switching from a cheap computer, maybe C64, from the old days to a computer from today. With Ultra HD 4K and much better, so optically it's such a glaring difference, yes. So in the analog itself we have the perception that we know now. It's analog, you could say, in quotation marks. And the perception is average. You can just perceive everything, you have a certain periphery and the like. In the digital self, it is as if your consciousness expands and you then get a crystal clear perception and of course access to all your intuitive knowledge, that you have conscious access, which in the analog self is only available as rudimentary intuition. Yes. The joke that still fascinates and still shocks me is that in the knower we actually really know everything. All knowledge is there. And if you then change your everyday situation, just pretend that you have no idea. That fascinates me. I can never figure this out at all. This is so fascinating. We know the solution for everything, and bang your back. Just pretend you have no idea. That's crazy. Is not that crazy? Oh, what have they done to you? What have you done? So? Yes. How can you imagine that with the agreements? So you can imagine it like this. We both, our two knowing selves, have practically agreed that we will shoot the video here in everyday life ourselves and how we will shoot the video. That's pretty much how you can imagine it. It's just that neither of us here know that we've agreed on this beforehand. That we are now shooting this video about the left and right self, i.e. the digital and analog self. Oh well. So the left self is the digital self and is connected to the right hemisphere of the brain. And the analog self is the right self and is connected to the left half. Enjoy the confusion and, of course, balance and connect and unite the two. Then, of course, you have access to both and can of course come into your own. That's the way. So if you manage to connect the analog self with the digital self, that is, that there is 100% conscious exchange, then you have the opportunity to enter the wholeness of the self. We notice this, for example, when we go to a friend's house during the day and visit the friend. And while we're chatting with the friend, it's quite possible that we'll switch from the analog self to the digital self. Discuss certain topics or certain behaviors or feelings or the like there and then switch back to the analog itself in order to then carry out the agreed elements there. The problem is that you don't actually notice the change in everyday life. Right, so that's actually how it is. You can imagine. The analog self is then paused, it then freezes. Then we switch to digital. Even there everything is discussed. Then you switch back to the analog itself and press the play button again and then reality continues there. And that's why you don't get it. And now you're probably wondering, why is that? Why are we doing this? And when I saw that, I showed that to myself. Practical. We want it that way. Because if we knew everything here, we wouldn't be able to experience things the way we experience them. We couldn't enjoy the coffee as drinking coffee. We just couldn't take things as they are. It's relatively difficult to express. In any case, we cannot have the experience we have if we knew everything. That means we practically deny ourselves, are in our limited everyday selves in order to be able to experience everything. Exactly. And we want it that way. How it is. We don't want to know that it is a conscious agreement. In any case, yes, it is a conscious agreement to make it work, so that we can continue to play the role in the analog self that is being asked of us at the moment. We wouldn't be able to play that otherwise. And sometimes you have to improvise in certain situations. So you then switch from the analog self to the digital self, where you get the information or makes the arrangements there and then switches back. And so you can improvise. We also find the same theme in Carlos Castaneda. But he describes himself differently than the right and the left. For Ramtha, for example, these are the dream self and the everyday self. Exactly. Yes, you can see it a little bit like that. Yes, even though you dream yourself, then you think of dreams again. Yes, of course that's not true, but the dreamer is the one who creates. Important to play here, but maybe you'll talk about Castaneda again. Yes, with Castaneda it is divided into right and left selves. The right self is the everyday self and the left self is the expanded knowing self. And Castaneda is also about the warrior, as Castaneda calls him, learning to switch to the left self. This is also equated there with a higher state of consciousness. It's definitely higher. Then you are very, very expanded on the left. And you know everything. That's true. And then when you switch back, she suddenly feels really, really limited. Yes. But only if you remember that you were in the left self. But mostly or almost always you don't remember that you were just in the digital self and switched back. Such changes can be noticed sometimes, at least signs of it. For example, if you lose the thread. So you're talking to a friend blah 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 and suddenly boom, you don't even know what it was about. Or you suddenly completely lost the thread of what topic you were on. And then you sit there and think, yes, what did I just say? What was that? What was it about? And these are such small signs that the thread just snapped. It's also clear, because you've switched from the everyday self to the digital self and switched back again. And that can then ensure that a kind of cut is created, in which the topic is then briefly forgotten. The other person has to give a tip, maybe what it was about. That happens quite often. So you can sometimes see that in discussions that one or the other loses his thread. Exactly. And now you're probably wondering how to get in touch with your knowing self or how to switch to it. And for that we have to become practically neutral and switch to the observer. Handy if you want a solution to a problem, for example. Then you withdraw, so to speak, become neutral, become an observer and let the answers come. Most of the time they come from the knower himself and you will notice that, because most of the time it sounds much wiser and smarter than how you would communicate in everyday life. So by dissociating, of course, one can manage to go into observer mode. That you accumulate so much energy in dissociation, by not actively thinking for a long time. And in doing so, you accumulate energy that enables an observer position, or that part of you or you feel like you are stepping back from reality. You distance yourself from everyday reality and then become an observer. And from the observer, if things go well, you can access the digital self. Or at least you will notice the change. This is, of course, also advisable for everyday life, to switch back to the conscious self from time to time or to become aware of what I am aware of at the moment. For example, when I go to the toilet. I'm going to the toilet right now and I'm observing that I'm going to the toilet right now. If I do this for a lot of little things a day, you integrate it practically and can switch more and more into the observer. That would be such a small task and a little trick. Exactly. Always become aware. Or you make yourself a coffee. Or whenever I make myself coffee, I become aware of what I'm doing. I am present, I am aware, so of course you come into the moment, into the now and don't judge. And exactly. That for general understanding, for the analog and digital self. And if you have any questions, do you know where you can do that? Otherwise, give us a like, support us, and we'll see you again in the next video, on the next topic. Bye.